destiny. Oh, your amen is standing on one leg. I say you fulfill destiny. In the name of Jesus. Before I continue, I want you to do this for 1 minute. Before I continue, I want you to do this for 1 minute. Bible says, the prodigal son, he said to his father, mark the word he said, give me my portion of your inheritance. As a result of what he said, he got into trouble. He became broke. Strayed in a foreign land. As a result of what he said. And one day, a morning like this, he came back to himself and said, even the servants in my father's house live better off. He got into trouble as a reason of what he said. And on that certain day, he got back his destiny as a result of what he then said again. And when he said, I will go back to my father, the father then said, go and kill the fattest cow for my son. As a result of what he said, his foundation was destroyed. And as a result of what he later said, his foundation was restored. I want you to kneel down on the floor now. Begin to say to the ground, everything that you want, on this ground I will prosper. On this ground I will excel. On this ground I will make it. On this ground I will shine. On this ground I will excel. On this ground I will not be limited. Say unto the ground, what you want for your destiny, say it now. The Bible says, say unto the righteous, it shall be well with you. On this land, in this Nigeria, it shall be well with you. In this Nigeria, I will make it. In this Nigeria, I will shine. In this Nigeria, I will be honored. In Jesus' name, I pray. Sit down for a moment. The Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong. Let those who have a weak foundation say to their destiny, be strong. Let those who have a poor foundation say to their destiny, I am rich. I come to meet some prayers this morning. I don't need all of you to say, I just need one or two people who can touch their neighbor and say something into their destiny. Or if your neighbor is not touching you, change neighbors. I need somebody who can say something to my destiny. Who can say to my destiny, you will shout in the name of Jesus. Say to their destiny, don't be selfish. Say to your neighbor's destiny, shine out. Shine forth. Come out now of your foundation into your destiny. In Jesus' name we are praying. Abraham had a faulty foundation, and God said unto him, get thee out of your foundation and walk into your destiny. Destiny was so bleak for Abraham. He didn't understand what the destiny was. God didn't tell him where he was going to. He didn't tell him what city he was going to be. He just said, go to a city, I will show you. And Abraham stepped out in faith. When God brings you to destiny, He doesn't tell you what it will be like. He doesn't give you an idea. You just see water. You just see water. You don't know if it is a lake, or a sea, or a river, or a creek. All you know is that you see water. That's how it is for destiny. You don't know you are going to be great. You don't know how great it will be. But I came to tell somebody, there's only one definition for greatness. And that is greatness. Big cannot define greatness. Mighty cannot define greatness. Greatness is greatness. I came to say to somebody this morning, your destiny is not big. Your destiny is not mid-size. Your destiny is not mighty. Your destiny is great. I say your destiny is great. Walk into your destiny today. Walk into your destiny today. In the name of Jesus. Ephesians 11 verse 1 verse 11,
it
says, in him we are predestinated according to the plan. Underline predestinated and underline plan of him that works. Underline works. Ephesians 1:11. Underline that works. All things in conformity with his will. Underline all things. Underline conformity. Underline his will. You are predestinated according to the plan of God that works all things in conformity with his will. Open your mouth and pray for 1 minute. Lord, let my destiny conform with your will. In the name of Jesus, let the destiny of my children conform with your will. Open your mouth and pray. Let my destiny conform with your will and your plan. In the name of Jesus. Because of time, I have to rush. Romans chapter 8 says, him whom he foreknew, God knew you before you were born. In that room and parlor where you and all your family members are staying, God knew you before you were born. Daddy Gio never wore sandal for 18 years. And God knew that he was going to have his own private jet. For 18 years he never wore a sandal. God knew he was going to have a PhD. God knew you before you were born. And then he predestinated you. A man that created me knows why I was created. He is my manufacturer. And if anything is wrong with me, I still have a warranty. If anything is wrong with me, I can go back to the factory. Oh, how many of you are back in the factory this morning? Oh, how many of you are back in the factory this morning? You came to the altar and the finisher of your destiny. And what did Romans 8 say? Whoever God created and predestined, he called.